Cyprus to climb to the highest peak. I'm on a mission, a grand project.
To climb the highest peak in every European country. There are about 49, and this is number 2.
The mission for the day is to get from Limassol all the way to Mount Olympus, which is just shy of 2,000 meters during a snowstorm. And it's getting pretty crazy.
All right, so woke up at about 6:30. Just walked all the way over here. Took about 30-40 minutes. So just gonna have a very light breakfast. Kind of kickstart my morning because I'm struggling a little bit. Oh, I didn't sleep very well.
I'm feeling alive again now that I had that coffee. And had a nice chat with some of the local gents. So cool.
What I've learned is that here, or I guess the coastal part of Cyprus, is usually 15 to 20 degrees warmer than in the mountains. In Troodos Mountains, it's about -2. So if it's precipitating, if there's precipitation, it should be snow. So that's better than rain, because otherwise I'm gonna be freezing. Most of my things are water resistant, except for my pants. We'll see. First step is to get on the bus.
Bus driver just stopped to give somebody a package and to let some passengers off, but he was so kind enough to come back here and ask me if I wanted to go back to Limassol, because he can't go any farther than Panoplatres because there's too much snow past that. So he's gonna drop me off there, and then I have to find a way to get towards the summit with a bunch of snow and no skis.
What I didn't know is that my idea to go cross-country skiing would be squashed by the next sequence of events.
I just went into the cafe that's just here, and they said they think it's possible that I can go this way. So the adventure begins.
Just 2 seconds later, I heard a whistle from the cafe. The family wanted to help me out by driving me to the trailhead.
No means no. You gotta trust these kinds of things, you know? Next option is to go along the road.
Chris said that some people going up might stop and pick me up on the way. So I'm gonna try it because I've got nothing to lose. It's really not even that cold out. The closer you get to Troodos Mountains, the more snow there is, and you need a 4x4. So it's all part of the adventure. Let's see.
Honestly, these roads aren't even that bad. So I have to stay vigilant and maybe get lucky and there'll be somebody going up. This lovely woman and her daughter just picked me up and took me probably a kilometer, but then it got a little bit icy, so they decided to turn back. I'm gonna keep going, see what happens. But look at this winter wonderland, it's so beautiful. I think I have another 5 kilometers. That's very humbling. These two gentlemen, they just stopped and they asked if I was okay, if I had water, if I have cell phone. And then as soon as they found out I'm from Canada, they're like, oh, this is normal for you. And I said, yes, the problem is the roads. And he said, don't have shame if you need to turn back. So I have no problem. If it's becoming very dangerous, I will go back. Right now, actually, the snow is harder, so it's easier to walk. It's not so slippery, but we'll keep going. They are so sweet. So another car with 4x4 just stopped. Wow, Cypriots and people in general are just so giving. It's so amazing. So I've got a bit of a trail to go here. They decided to go back because their friends don't have chains and it's getting pretty crazy. So I really did luck out. Visibility is absolute shite, but it's all part of the adventure. It's all part of the journey. Let's go. I'm almost at the top. All the endorphins, all the good stuff. Oh, I'm feeling it all. This is awesome. It's only 2 degrees. Yes, born for this shit.
Feeling in my bones, I can feel it in my veins.
Don't mind me, just climbing every peak in Europe. Oh, nearly at the top. Let's go, let's go.
The peak of Cyprus. Oh my gosh. Legally, I can't go any farther because there's a military base, but this is the peak.
Oh my gosh, peak number two. Oh, I'm absolutely ecstatic. I can't believe I did it. Oh, not by myself, obviously. So many amazing people helped me and so many kind souls just knew that it could be possible. Not a single person doubted that I could make it up here. I kept telling them, they're like, I think you're a bit crazy. I'm like, yeah, I know. I mean, the next step is to actually get down. I made it here, so I feel like I can make it down. It just feels so good. Lunchtime. Packed my sandwiches. I'm only gonna eat one now, but you never know. Survival tactics. Hello. Beautiful day, huh? I'm just doing a video for YouTube.
No problem.
Pretty good. I mean, I think anything tastes good when you've worked this hard. Take a photo.
Snow is falling a little bit faster, a little bit harder. And make my way down the mountain now. So I'm really hoping somebody's gonna be going down.
I walked for about 2 kilometers without seeing anyone. I was getting nervous. The first car I saw kept driving.
I've literally just been on the most incredible afternoon I could have imagined on this crazy adventure.
I didn't doubt or give up. Luckily, Theo and Yota rolled down their windows and welcomed me into their warm car. We exchanged stories, and their grandnephew, Constantino, quizzed me on my life. I loved his curiosity. Once we arrived to Panoplatres, I met their nephew, Cristo, and his wife, Marilena, and their two children, George and Eliana, who reminded me of my own niece, who is the same age.
Yeah, what do you want to say?
Hello?
They then invited me for an amazing traditional Cypriot lunch. I honestly didn't feel much, as these experiences are so rare and so special that I wanted to be 100% present. Afterwards, we drove the scenic routes through their childhood towns and all the way back to Limassol. I never could have guessed how welcoming, warm, and hospitable they would be when I stuck my thumb out.
Thank you all so much. You made this day a day I will never forget. And thank you to you for watching and your constant support. It really means a lot to me. I can't stress enough, after a day like today, go out and have an adventure. Go out and take life by the horns and enjoy. There's an amazing world with amazing people out there and so much to explore. So with that, take care, my friends.